Iran's advancements in drone technology are profoundly altering the landscape of global conflicts. Iranian drones are being utilized in various countries, including Sudan, Syria, and Russia. These drones are becoming more advanced and are being used by various militias and militaries worldwide. It is reported that Ukraine shot down an Iranian drone in April 2023, which had a navigational component produced in China. Iran's ascent in the realm of drone technology is underscored by its collaborative efforts with China. This partnership highlights Iran's growing stature in this domain. It has been revealed that in the past 2 years, Iran has significantly increased its production of drones in at least 5 different countries across South America and Central Asia. The Russian military used hundreds of unmanned aircraft manufactured by Iran during its offensive operations in the ongoing war with Ukraine. Russia has launched wave after wave of Iranian kamikaze drones at Ukrainian energy facilities and urban centers in recent months. Furthermore, Russia has recently started manufacturing Iranian drones to use in the ongoing war in Ukraine. The American military experts predict that it may take between 5 to 10 years for the West to develop effective methods to counter Iranian drones. After the UN restriction on Iran's import and export of missile-related technology expired in 2023, missiles and drones with a range of 300 kilometers still remained restricted. Despite this, Beijing continued to supply drone parts to Tehran as the two countries had maintained diplomatic and military relations for several decades. Despite the sanctions, Iran's drone industry is thriving due to innovative methods to circumvent them. It is a crucial part of Iran's military strategy, allowing it to extend its power and influence beyond its borders. Iran's military-industrial complex had produced thousands of advanced drones used for surveillance, reconnaissance, and combat used against U.S. forces as well as American allies in the Middle East. The drones, unmanned aerial vehicles, have become one of the greatest assets of the Iranian-backed Axis of Resistance, a network of militias in Iraq, Syria, Lebanon, and Yemen, and one of the greatest dangers to Iran's regional rivals. Iran has at least 10 different models of suicide drones, which explode on impact. They can be as accurate as a ballistic missile, but they can fly lower to evade radar. Iran's largest suicide drones, such as the Arash series, can carry nearly 260 kilograms, 575 pounds, of explosives. They have ranges of 2,000 kilometers. Iran has more than a dozen models of combat drones that can attack ground, sea or air targets and then return to base. Larger models, such as the Shahid 149, have ranges of 2,000 kilometers and can carry up to 500 kilograms, 1,100 pounds, of munitions or electronic equipment. Most of Iran's combat drones, including long-range models, also have surveillance capabilities. Their functions range from taking photographs and video footage to marking targets for bombers, fighters or other drones. Several of Iran's drones were modeled on captured US drones, including the Predator, Reaper, Sentinel and Scan-Eagle 5 as well as the Israeli Hermes drone. Iran has mimicked the shapes of the UAVs but has not necessarily replicated all of the sophisticated onboard electronics. Iran has, however, succeeded in importing US-made parts almost certainly through intermediaries for less advanced drones, including the Shahed-136. Tehran began exporting drone technology to Hezbollah, a Shiite militia in Lebanon, in the 2000s. In 2004, Hezbollah became the world's first non-state actor to use military drones. And in 2006, Hezbollah, with Iran's help, used armed drones during its 34-day war with Israel. Since 2015, Iran has reportedly launched drones on Saudi oil fields, dissident groups in Pakistan and Iraqi Kurdistan, and jihadi groups in Syria. In the early 2020s, Iran developed a new generation of suicide drones with advantages over ballistic missiles that had comparable ranges. They were cheaper. One Shahed-136 reportedly cost $20,000. They were more portable. The Arash, about 10 feet long, could reportedly be launched from a regular car. Their parts were easier to smuggle. And suicide drones were harder to detect either visually or by radar than ballistic missiles. They were not as noisy. They do not produce high thermal signatures, which makes them harder than ballistic missiles to track by satellites. Iran has exported drones or the technology to 6 other proxy militias and 5 governments, including Russia, Venezuela, Sudan, Ethiopia, and Tajikistan. Iran's advancements in drone technology are profoundly altering the landscape of global conflicts. Iranian drones are being utilized in various countries, including Sudan, Syria, and Ukraine. These drones are becoming more advanced and are being used by various militias and militaries worldwide.